Hello everybody, the Karelian conflict is finally here. So this is the first campaign for Star Wars Armada and I'm really excited, so I'm going to go ahead and open it up. It was actually a smaller box when I than I expected when I bought it. I figured it would be, you know, maybe closer in size to the game box, but I guess when you're only having cards. So here's the guide, all the rules. I'll definitely be reading through this very soon. And here are some score sheets. I'm sure there's PDFs of them in order to print out additional ones. So this is fun. Fleet roster, so you can have multiple fleets. Go ahead and create them. Total number of points. The battles. So, what the flagship will be. What upgrades are on it. Definitely going to need a lot of these if you're going to play often, that's for sure. Here's a little star map. Fortunately, this is just poster paper, so I suspect it's going to get dog-eared by people who play regularly. So here is the star map. So center point, different asteroid belts, different planets. It's definitely something I have to gonna go more into. It all leads it to Corella. It's definitely interesting. So a lot of potential battles, a lot of different points, a lot of changes from game to game, that's for sure. Well, I'll fold that up later. Lots of new token, or no, these are, they look like stickers. This is probably like for some of the unique squadrons maybe. Lots of punch outs. Anyone that plays Armada already has tons of these, that's for sure. Let's see if there's anything. On the other side, here's the new dust cloud, as well as an additional station, since some of the campaigns now have two stations in the campaigns. Different officer tokens. I'm assuming these are probably spies and diplomats, probably. Yeah, same on the other side. Here are the unique squadrons. I was curious how they were going to do that, of whether or not they would. So it's actually the unique squadron on both sides. For, like, these new heroes. I was wondering if they were going to give us additional fighters, but it looks like they're not. Yeah, I was wondering how this was going to go. So, unfortunately, these aren't necessarily standalone. You definitely have to have the other fighter expansion packs in order to play with them. And then the new objectives, including the new green ones, which are like have very strong defense advantages for sure. Lots of new objectives. It's definitely going to be interesting. Create a lot of new variation off of the tournament rules now that at least the red, yellow, and light blue ones will be tournament available. Here are the new squadrons that we got a good preview of. I'm definitely looking forward to a lot of these. This Saber Squadron is going to be interesting with a snipe of 4, but it loses its counter. Sienna Ray, I'm really looking forward to her. I loved her in Lost Stars. I definitely think she's going to be a great addition. Captain Jonas, I think he's going to be really cool. Rogue Squadron, I definitely want that. 1 point extra and it gets Rogue, definitely worth it. Thor Vexley could be pretty interesting. Green Squadron could be useful if you really want to go fast and heavy. Her counter is going to be crazy. The fact that she has counter 3 and the crits also count as damage, she will be able to wipe a lot of enemies out just on her counter. Oh, interesting. Dagger Squadron with the B-Wing. They actually have Swarm, so now it's not just the Z-95 Headhunters that have Swarm. So that's actually a pretty good addition. It makes Z-95 Headhunters a little bit more useful. And here are the different stations, the armed stations, definitely. It's going to be interesting. So this is the Carillion Conflict. I'm a little bit disappointed that it doesn't provide some squadrons, but I guess for the price, I shouldn't have been all that surprised. So I hope this has been helpful, and I'm looking forward to making some recording of the game soon. Goodbye.